Welcome to the second of three short videos introducing you to development with Visual LANSA. LANSA's single skill set allows you to build applications for desktop, web, and mobile without needing to know any of the underlying technologies. In part one, I built this simple inquiry application with a header, list, and detailer, with data being served by a server module. Over the next few minutes, I'll add sorting to the list and include a thumbnail image for each of the employees. I'll add an image to the detailer, and a file picker will support selection of a new one. Finally, when I save, we'll see LANSA's repository rules protecting the database. So I'll start by adding sorting and an image to the list. I'll drag the employee thumbnail field from the repository onto the list, which will automatically convert it to an image column. I'll add a little formatting for the cell, and then I'll move the column to the left-hand side. Then I just need to make sure that the image fits in the available space as best it can and resize the column to an appropriate width. So that's the image column sorted, but while I'm here, I'll take a moment to make the rows a bit taller and to remove the unnecessary grid lines. I'll also turn on sorting for the list so that LANSA's client-side runtime can sort the data without needing to go back to the server. There are no additional coding requirements for the list, so I'll go to the server module and add the thumbnail to the list of data being returned. The images are stored in a separate database table, allowing me to use them as I would any other type of data. So I'll add a fetch statement to get the employee image from the employee image file while I'm loading the list of employees, and I'll be able to return all the data and images within a single transaction. So that's the list finished. Let's have a look at the result. Each of the items now has a thumbnail image, and when I click on the title column header, the data is immediately sorted. With the list complete, I'll move on to the editor, and I'll start by adding a file picker. When clicked, this will allow me to select a file from the operating system. As ever, I'll use the LANSA layout to help position and size the control, and then I'll apply a draw style to make it appear like all the other subheadings. I'll give it a caption, and then I'll select an image from the repository. Finally, as I'd like it at the top, I'll change its display position to 1 and let the LANSA layout reorganize the screen for me. I'll now go through much the same process with an image control, positioning it just below the file picker. With the UI changes complete, I'll now add some supporting code. When a file is selected, I'll show the image in the image control and store it in the employee image field, ready to be sent to the server. I also need to show the image when I load an employee. So I'll include the employee image field in the set of data being returned, and when the find completes, I'll use it to populate the image. With the client side complete, I'll now make a change to the server processing. I'll add the employee image field to the group of fields being returned and then populate it by reading from the image table. LANSA's autocomplete features will help me fill in the single line required, and with a compile, you'll be able to see the result. The employee image is now visible, and clicking on the details subheading allows me to select a new one. Here we see Windows Explorer. If this were a mobile or tablet, we'd have access to the device camera and the picture gallery. Next, I'll add the save functionality, and I'll start by adding a toolbar to the header with a simple drag and drop. This is a simple self-contained part that I made ahead of time, so I need only attach it to the right-hand side, and the header changes are complete. I'll now return to the editor to handle the save processing. When the application fires its saving event, I'll run the editor save routine. This will clear any existing messages and execute the save routine that was generated in the server module in part one. When this completes, if there are any validation messages to be shown, they'll be presented to the user. So let's see how that works at runtime. When I clear the name fields and attempt to save the record, we see the validation rules protecting the database and providing valuable feedback for the user. I'll finish off part two by allowing users to create an employee. When the application fires its creating event, I'll clear all the fields and use a default image from the repository. I'll then return to the design and add placeholders for the name fields. These will appear as pale text in the input box, providing a hint to the user as to what to enter. So with that complete, I'll let LANSA's single-click compile do the work, and you'll be able to see the result. Clicking the Add button clears the fields and applies a default image, and of course, trying to save the employee sees LANSA's repository business rules protecting the database once more. And that's the end of part 2. I'll be back with part 3 to show you how we can adapt this application to run on tablet and mobile, all without needing to know HTML, JavaScript, or CSS.